Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Jacobsen and I'm a Technical Product Marketing Manager at Unity. One of the things I have the privilege of working on at Unity is the releases. For me, personally, I'm always excited when we start preparing for a new release. It's not uncommon that we have several hundreds of features and improvements, way too much to cover it all. And hence, my job is also to help pick out, along with my teammates, some of those features which we believe are the most valuable and relevant to call out. Preparing for a release is hence an opportunity for me personally to look inside what's in the box, what's new, and understand what problems we can now solve with all the new tooling available. That said though, while new is always exciting, I'm actually often more excited about the little things, the improvements which makes it easier to work in the editor, which makes iteration times faster, and particularly when the workflows just feels a little bit smoother. At Unity, we believe the world is a better place with more creators in it. And in our team, we work in close collaboration with many other teams inside Unity to help provide guidance on how you can be successful with all the new tools. This includes everything from creating blog posts, technical talks, to helping out with the tutorials and with the internal sample projects. In this session, I'll be covering 10 features from the recent Unity 2019 LTS, which we believe can help you and your team be even more productive. The features I picked are with particular programmer in mind, but several of these features are just general workflows. So if you identify yourself with more of an artist than a programmer, there might still be something for you. I'll try to keep it short. This session is supposed to be more of an inspiration rather than an extensive starting guide. However, I'll also provide some links and tips to where you can get even more resources along the way in the description. Before we dive in, let's quickly recap on Unity 2019 LTS. As per its definition, Unity 2019 LTS simply continues where I left off from 2019.3. It includes everything from the previous tech stream releases of 2019. So in other words, everything which released in 19.1, 19.2, and 19.3, but just with all the updates and fixes which were added to it since the release of those. Furthermore, the LTS is supported with bi-weekly updates for a two-year period from the time of its release. This means that if you're past the pre-production phase and you don't want to add more features, you don't need those, but you just want to stabilize your actual production, then we recommend you use the latest LTS version. If you're in the pre-production phase, that is maybe still prototyping a few game mechanics or testing out some of the new features and considering whether to use those in the upcoming production, then the tech stream is generally where you want to be. And at the time of this recording, the beta of 20.2 is actually now available if you want to check that out. To summarize, in 2019, we had 3 tech stream releases. These were followed by the 2019 LTS. This year, we only have 2 tech stream releases, 20.1, which was released early in the year, and 20.2, which at the time of this recording is available in beta. These will be followed by the 2020 LTS next year. The reason why we have 2 releases in 2020 is that we want a longer stabilization phase. We want to allow more user feedback in the alpha and the beta cycle, and we want to do what we can to create a more robust and stable release by having this updated cadence. To provide some context for the features I'll be showing throughout the presentation, I'll be leveraging the project called John Lemon, which is available from our education team. It's a project which is designed for beginners to get started with the coding with Unity, but it does also come with some really cool assets which we can use to make things a little bit more interesting. The project is available free and you can find it in the asset store. I'll also provide a link in the description. Okay, so let's dig into some of the new features which we cherry-picked for this presentation. 10 new features in Unity 2019 LTS, which we believe can help speed up your productivity. Here are the 10 features which we'll be covering in this session. We provided timestamps for each of them, so you can just jump to the sections which you find interesting and skip the ones which you don't. It can be difficult to locate specific content when you're building large projects. Quick search helps with that. It lets you find anything in the editor from assets, game objects, settings, to even menu items. Hence, Quick Search was really designed to help speed up your workflow significantly. To access Quick Search, simply go to the Help menu or use the keyboard shortcut. then type in your search. You can interact directly with the search results. So in this case, where I'm searching for prefab, it takes me straight to the inspection where I can change its properties. But I can actually also pull it directly into the scene or interact with it in many other ways. Another example of where quick search is super useful is in terms of the different settings and windows. In this case, I can actually search directly from the project settings and will take me straight to that window. Quick search is available as a package with 2019 LTS, and hence you need to install it from the package manager. Once you install it, it's a good idea to run the setup wizard to configure preferences and get the optimal results. The performance can depend quite a bit in terms of the size of the project, so customizing it to your needs is often preferable. The shortcut manager gives you an interactive visual interface and a set of APIs which make it easier to manage editor hotkeys. You can find the shortcut manager under Edit and then Shortcuts. From the window, you can easily visualize existing bindings and customize new shortcuts to your preference and workflows. This way, it helps visualize and address if there are any conflicts between shortcuts. As an example, if multiple packages use the same shortcut, the editor will actually also trigger a notification and offer you options for handling the conflict. Presets allow you to customize the default state of just about anything in Unity, but without having to write any code. Hence, they can really benefit you in streamlining repetitive tasks or to ensure design decisions by enforcing standards and project templating. In this example, I would like to reuse the settings from this shader, apply it on the light. I'll just change the color, but presets can capture multiple changes. So I save it as a preset. I can then easily apply it to another game object with just a few clicks. This is a simple example, but imagine if you got thousands of game objects and multiple scenes to keep track of. Presets can also be quite helpful in the process of documenting design decisions, as well as keeping your team aligned by making it easy to apply these rules across large scenes to ensure consistency. As the scene becomes more detailed, it often helps to temporarily hide specific objects, so it's more easy to see the relevant context and edit without obstructions. You can, of course, just deactivate the game objects, but in a large-scale scene, that is not really the most optimal workflow. Instead, you can now use the scene visibility controls. These allow you to quickly hide and show objects in the scene view, but without changing the object's in-game visibility. To use the controls, simply click the eye icon left of the game objects. Then ensure the global setting is on. This way, objects are now hidden in the scene view, but not in the game view. With Unity 2019 LTS, we also replace the old asset database version 1 with the new version 2. New features include asset dependency tracking, and you can now also have multiple revisions stored in the asset database. This can help speed up your platform switching, as well as when swapping between previously imported versions of assets. The new asset database is part of a larger initiative to improve import pipeline workflows, which lay the foundation for a more reliable, performant, and scalable pipeline. In short, if you're working on large projects, this will help speed up your import times significantly when combined with some of the other initiatives which are in the works, and hence will be made available in the upcoming releases. If you're not quite sure if the asset database is already enabled, simply go to Project Settings, then Editor, and then check if version V2 is enabled. We updated the editor console with clickable stack trace links. This means that you can now jump directly into the source code line for any function call listed in the stack. We also added a small search tool, which allows you to filter your console entries. Another update in 2019 LTS is that we moved the code editor integrations, also known as IDEs, from core to packages. With that, we also exposed our C# APIs. To use Visual Studio or Visual Studio Code or any other IDE, go to Package Manager and install the appropriate package. Once downloaded and installed, go to Preferences, go under External Tools, and then select the new IDE. For those of you using Visual Studio, we've recently published a blog post with 10 tips in terms of how to be more productive with the IDE. You'll find a link in the description. Another foundational feature in 2019 LTS is the new incremental garbage collector. As its name implies, it provides you a new way to handle memory management. With the old garbage collector, the program would pause in its execution, handle the memory management, and then resume. For larger projects with real-time gameplay mechanics, this could be a problem because it could lead to occasional frame stutter. The new incremental garbage collector allows you to split up the memory management into multiple slices. That means that instead of having one lengthy interruption of your program, it will do multiple shorter collections. While this will not make your program run faster, it does mean that you will experience much fewer DC spikes, and hence a much smoother gameplay experience. It will distribute the workload over multiple frames rather than one. To enable the new incremental garbage collector, go to your project settings, go to the player, scroll down under settings, and enable. If you'd like to learn more about how the incremental garbage collection works, check out this blog post which we did some time ago. When investigating performance through the profiler window, you were able to see profile data from 300 frames at a time. That didn't, however, always give you enough time to catch the frames you really care about. With configurable frame count, you can now extend that capture window from 300 to 2000 frames. To change this, simply go to the Preferences menu, go under Profile, and then change frame count there. Other improvements include deep profile support. When you build a player with deep profiling support, you are able to record timestamps when entering and exiting C# methods. However, this C# instrumentation might come with a bit of performance overhead, so we also added the option to toggle it off per player. Finally, we introduced call stacks for managed allocations in players. This allows you to see the C# function where a DC allocation is coming from when you're profiling the players. If you'd like to learn more about profiling and some of the newer features, we highly recommend our Unite Now session, Introduction to Profiling, from earlier this year. We'll provide a link in the description. The last feature I wanted to call out is the new Enter Play Mode options. For the 2019 LTS, this feature is still experimental, and hence I would emphasize that it's not really recommended for live productions. But if you want to give it a go, if you're in the prototyping phase and curious to test it out, by all means, give it a try. When your projects get complex, the Unity editor can be quite slow when you're entering play mode. And that's actually why we introduced this new option. With the new options, you can disable domain and or scene reloading from the enter play mode process when there are no new code changes. In our test, we found that it can save you up to 90% of the iteration time. To access the options, go to Edit, Project Settings, go to Editor, scroll all the way down, and here you find the option to enable the interplay mode options. You can also decide whether you want to include both scene and domain reload. Find more info on how to configure play mode in our documentation. That wraps up our 10 tips for this session. Obviously, there is so much more to dive into, and picking which 10 to include was actually a bit tricky, but we hope you found it useful, and we hope you can apply them to your projects. As always, we are very open to feedback, so let us know if you like the format, and we might do a second session as well. Finally, be sure to check out our Unite Now page for other sessions which might also inform and inspire you.